by in a circuit. If you are analyzing a circuit, in a circuit you, just 1 minute, any comment? Nothing. Okay. Okay. In the circuit you want to identify, is it a PMOS or NMOS? So there are different standards followed in different organizations. These are some common symbols that we are using for NMOS or PMOS. So the very first thing is you want to identify the transistor that you are using. Is it a PMOS or a NMOS? Once it is identified, what is the next step is you want to identify the gate of the terminal. It is easy, gate of the terminal is a different one that is connected to the backside. So you can easily identify that that is the gate of the transistor. Then drain and source is identical in nature. So the difficult process that you have to follow is how to identify drain and source of a transistor. So the simple rule is, you will first identify which is the source. For PMOS, source is the highest potential point. So for easiness of identification, can say P stands for positive, so that is the highest. So source of PMOS transistor is the terminal which is connected to the highest potential. And if you are going to NMOS, N source of NMOS is the lowest terminal point. That is the terminal that is connected to the lowest potential. So P stand, again, for easiness of identification, you can use a short that like this, that is PMOS P stands for positive, NMOS N stands for negative. So source of PMOS is the highest potential, source of NMOS is the lowest potential. So opposite is the drain. So once you identify this, then what's your job is, next, find out what is the potential of VGS, the potential between gate and source, and the potential between drain and source. So you have to identify the potential VGS and VDS. Once you have identified VGS, then we have to put a question. That question is simple. Is VGS is greater than or equal to VT?
Sir, PPT kaanunnilla.
PPT I am cutting that I have a board advanced machine, but there is a problem that I identify now because you are getting a mirror image. Is it? How it is displayed in your terminal? Is it a mirror image of what I am written here?
No, sir. Sir, inde ipo audible aayittulla idu mathre kaanunnullu. Matti site kaanunnilla sir.
Okay, that is, I just withdraw the slide, but I am going for the video mode. If it is bandwidth is less, you may have a problem. So anyhow, I am just discarding that because I want to just write one thing here. But I don't think I can use the video mode. Okay. Okay, I'm going back to the slides. Now it is viewable. Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. The problem that we have is if you are switching to video mode, If your bandwidth is not enough, you cannot view the video. Okay. So we are forced to use slides only. Otherwise, what I am exactly planned is I will go for in between whiteboard writing, but I feel now it is impossible. Okay. So once you identified how much is VGS, the potential of VGS, then your job is find out is VGS is greater than or equal to VT. If VGS is greater than or equal to VT, then your transistor is on, otherwise it is off. Because for digital circuit, there will not be any other condition. Can you follow what I am saying? If you are going for analog circuit design, there will be one condition, that is, if VGS is greater than VT, we will define it as on. Then we will check for is VDS is greater than VGS minus VT or less than VGS minus VT. Depend upon that, we will define it is in saturation or linear mode. Okay. But for a digital circuit, that condition is not rising. Our question is only is VGS is greater than VT. If VGS is greater than VT, then we will define it as it is in on condition. That is, it will act as a on switch. If VGS is less than VT, then it will act as an off switch. Okay. So next is how an inverter will work. An inverter circuit is whatever you are giving at the input, the output will be inverted. That is, you are giving input as 1, you are expecting an output of 0. If you are giving an input of 0, you are expecting an output of 1. So if you are looking at the inverter circuit, you can see at the top, it is a PMOS. At the bottom, it is an NMOS. And if you analyze the conditionalities that we have provided earlier, for a PMOS, the highest potential point is source. So the top point that we are using here, this one is source, and the bottom one is drain. Similarly, if you are going to the bottom device, that is NMOS, for an NMOS, the source point is the lowest point. So the ground point is source and the top point is drain. So once you identified it, then what's your job is find out VGS of both the transistors. So if you are assuming you are giving a input that is equal to 1, we refer V1 is equal to VDD, then what will happen is VG of PMOS is VDD, VS of PMOS is VDD, so VGS becomes 0. So naturally, the PMOS act as an open circuit or off. So there will not be any connection from VDD to capacitor, that is at the output. Now, if you check the VGS of NMOS, that is the bottom transistor, gate is at VDD, source is at ground, so VGS is naturally VDD, VDD is greater than VT, so NMOS is on. So what will happen is, if the capacitor is discharged, the NMOS may not have, that is, your output is already at zero state, the capacitor may not, the transistor may not have any role. If your capacitor, that is, output is already at VDD, that is on, then the NMOS will provide a short circuit to the ground. Naturally, the capacitor will discharge and it becomes 0. So if you are connecting an on at the input, output becomes 0. Then, if you are going for a different condition, that is, you are giving a 0 at the input. When you are giving a 0 at the input means you are connecting a 0 potential at the input. That is VG of PMOS and VG of NMOS is 0. So going to PMOS, can identify that VG of PMOS is 0, VS of PMOS is VDD, So VGS is equal to VDD. Then you are asking the question, that is VGS is greater than VT. So VGS of PMOS is VDD. It is greater than VT. So PMOS is on, or it acts as a short circuit. When it is acting as a short circuit, a VDD is directly connected to the output capacitor. So the capacitor will charge to VDD. Then we will check, is it any possibility of discharge? So for finding out the possibility of discharge, we'll go to the NMOS device. In NMOS device, VG is equal to zero, VS is equal to zero. So VGS is equal to zero minus zero, that is zero. So VGS is equal to zero. That means VGS is not greater than or equal to VT. So naturally, NMOS is at off condition, or it has acted as an open circuit. So the capacitor may not have a discharge path. The capacitor have only a charge path, so it charges to VDD. That means output is at on. So if you are connecting an input of zero, the output will be at on. So this is a basic working of an inverter circuit. That is, if you are giving an input on, you will get an output zero. If you are giving an input zero, you will get an output on. But what is the significance of this circuit, that is inverter circuit, in static CMOS design? And later, when we are going to the domino circuit design, is that we will just generalize this circuit something like this. That is, at the top portion, all PMOS devices are called pull-up devices. And the bottom portion, all NMOS devices are called pull-down devices. Because when you have more than one input, depend upon number of inputs or number of combinations that you are using, there will be N PMOS at the top. All the PMOS joined, combined together, we will call it as a pull-up device. And bottom devices, we will call it as a pull-down device. And when you are going for gates, that is, if you are taking an AND gate or a NOR gate, NOT gate or anything, what is the thing is, it is not like an inverter. It have N inputs. So you have to provide minimum. So you have to provide minimum N transistors in the pull up and pull down if you are going for a static CMOS design. Okay. That is, in a static CMOS design, there'll be a simple design rule. What is the design rule is, if you have any function to be implemented, the static CMOS will implement only negative logic of that. What is the meaning of that? You can implement an AND gate, but the implementation is actually an AND gate. Sorry, NAND gate. Then you have to connect an inverter that becomes AND. Can you follow what I am saying? Hello, someone can give a feedback by chat. Can you follow if you have any problem? Okay. Because we are moving to an important area. If you know these things, then you can design any static CMOS circuit. That's why I'm just want to ensure. That is, all the static CMOS circuit, there'll be a portion, that is upper portion. Upper portion is all PMOS devices. There be a portion that is lower portion, or lower portion have NMOS devices. Okay. And joining of this NMOS and PMOS device will be an output point. So PMOS devices are called pull-up devices, and NMOS devices are called pull-down devices. So any logic you want to implement, actually you can implement only and negative logic of that. That is, somebody asking you want to implement A plus AB plus B, BC, then actually what you are implementing is AB plus BC the whole bar, then take an inverter at the output, then you will get AB plus BC. Okay. So what is the role of circuit is something like this. That is, if you are going for the next slide, then you can easily follow. That is here the implementation of an AND gate, NAND gate. How it look like is, you have two inputs A and B. Top, that is output is AB bar. The top is PMOS devices and bottom is NMOS devices. So if it is a product, now we are sticking on only how to design a pull-up device. That is, if it is a product, that is A, B, C or something like that, then all the transistors will be connected parallelly. If it is a plus, then if it is A plus B, then naturally you have to connect it serially. So you are seeing two transistors in parallel means it is a product. Two transistors in series means it is a sum. That is, it is an OR operation. Okay. So you want to implement AB, the whole bar. It can be implemented directly because it is a negative logic. AB means you have to connect a PMOS transistor. You have to connect another PMOS transistor. Then it is a product. So you have to connect it parallelly. So both the transistors source are connected to VDD. Both the transistors drains are shorted and it is shorted to the output. So it is a parallel combination at the pull-up device. It is a product. Now, at the bottom, you have to go for the ulta. Ulta means opposite of that. Because if two transistors are in parallel, that is two PMOS transistors are in parallel, then you have to compensate or you have to connect two NMOS transistors are in series. That is for a NAND gate. It is a product. So PMOS are parallel, NMOS are series. So we will not discuss both because it will create a confusion. So a product means it is a parallel combination in PMOS. As or it is a plus operation means it is a series operation in PMOS. Okay. Now we will check how the transistor will work. You take a combination that is 0-0. When 0-0 is the input, for a NAND gate, output is 1. So we will go for the input A is equal to 0. So gate of M3 is 0. Source of M3 is VDD. So VGS is VDD. So M3 is 1. And B is 0. So gate of M4 is 0. Source of M4 is VDD, so VGS is VDD, so M4 is on. So transistor M3 and M4 on, that means the capacitor at the output is connected to VDD. So the capacitor have a chance to charge to VDD. Then we have to check, is it a possibility it is discharged? So we will check M1 and M2 condition. M1 is connected to B is 0, so gate of M1 is 0, source of M1 is 0. Naturally, VGS of M1 is not connected to, VGS of M1 is 0. VGS of M1 is 0 means M1 is off. M1 is off means M2 is not connected to ground. So there will not be any possibility M2, even if it is conducting, it can conduct. But in this case of M2, we can check A is 0, so VG is 0, VS is also 0, so VGS is 0, so M2 is off. So M3 and M4 is on, the capacitor can charge. M1 and M2 is off, so the capacitor cannot discharge. So output will be 1. So A and B is equal to 0 means output is on. Now you go for a combination that is A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. A is equal to 0 means M3, M2 have the same status. That is M3 is on, M2 is off, and M1 is on. But M1 is on means M1 is on and M4 is on. Why M4 is on? You check. Sorry, M4 is off and M1 is on. Why M4 is off is, you check B is on. B is on means VDD. VG of M4 is VDD. VS of M4 is VDD. So VGS of M4 is VDD minus VDD, that is zero. So VGS zero means it is off. So M4 is off. But in case of M3, A is zero. So VGF M3 is zero. VS of M3 is VDD. So VGS is VDD minus zero, that is VDD. So M3 is on. So M3 can charge the output capacitance. So going to M1, VG is equal to 1. That is VG of M1 is VDD, VGS is ground. So it is connected to ground, M1 is on. Now moving to M2, M2A is 0, that is VG of M2 is 0, VS of M2 is connected to ground. So 0 minus 0, 0. So naturally M2, VGS is equal to 0, M2 is off. M2 is off means that switch is on. Sorry, that switch is off. M1 is on. So it is known from output if you are moving, M2 is off. So the circuit is break. So it is not connected to ground. So the capacitor may not have a possibility to discharge to charge. So this condition also output is on. So the condition is A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1, output is equal to 1. If you go for the reverse of that, that is B, A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0, can find out that M3 is off, M4 is on, M2 is on, but M1 is off. So the charging path is completed, discharging path is not completed, so output again become on. Now we are going for a typical case, that is A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. Only when A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1, if you go for M3, A is equal to 1 means VG of M3 is VDD, VS of M3 is VDD. So VGS is equal to VDD minus VDD, that is equal to 0. Then VGS is equal to 0 means M3 is off. So through M3, the capacitor will not charge. Now go to the condition of B. B is equal to 1, that means VG of M4 is equal to VDD. VS of N4 is equal to VDD. So find out what is VGS, that is VDD minus VDD, that is 0. So VGS of M4 is equal to 0, that means M4 is off. That means M4 also not provide a charge for, sorry, path for charging. M3 and M4 will not provide a path for charging, so the capacitor will not have any possibility of charging. Now, if the transistor is the capacitor is already charged, the output capacitor is already charged, then what will happen? We'll go to the condition of M1. B is equal to 1, that is VG of M1 is equal to VDD, and VS of M1 is equal to ground. So VGS is equal to VDD. VGS is equal to VDD means the transistor is on. Naturally, the ground will be shifted to the top of ground of our source of M2. So M2 is VG of M2, A is equal to VDD. VS of M2 is ground. So VGS is equal to VDD minus 0. VGS of M2 is VDD. So VDS, VGS of M2 is VDD means M2 is on. So transistor M1 is on and M2 is on. That means there will be a direct path from output to the ground for discharging. So the capacitor is previously charged to VDD. When this condition rises, A1 and B is equal to 1, the capacitor will discharge. Then if the capacitor is previously discharged, then naturally there will not be any action. It will be hold at condition 0. So it will satisfy all the truth table, that is A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, output is on. A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1, output is on. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0, output is on. And both A and B is equal to 1, output tends to 0. This is the truth table of a NAND gate and it follows exactly the same conditions. So So before going to discuss Norgate, do you have any feedback or any discussion? We can go for that. Anyone want to comment or anything to be clarified? Can give a chat. Otherwise, we will continue. So I'm not getting any feedback from your side because I am not sure are you there or not, but I'm getting. Just wait, there'll be a chat as from Arjun. Yes, okay, I'm proceeding. Okay, once we analyzed the NAND gate, the NOR gate is exactly the reverse. That is, NOR function is A plus B the whole bar. It is a plus sign. The PMOS must be in series. So PMOS is series, naturally NMOS has to be parallel. So we can take the conditions one by one. So this is the criteria, you have to learn how to design the pull-up devices. Pull-up devices, it is a product, it has to be, that is, you have a term ABC, you have to draw three transistors, M1, M2, M3, all are in parallel, then it becomes ABC. You want to implement a function that is A plus B plus C, you have to draw three transistors in series, ABC, then it becomes A plus B plus C. But the output function you are getting is negative, that means naturally it is A plus B plus C the whole bar. So connect one more inverter at the output, then you will get A plus B plus C. Okay. So here it is a NOR gate. So NOR function is a plus function. So naturally the PMOS devices, that is pull-up devices, are in series and pull-down devices are in parallel. Now we will check. NOR gate will give an output that is equal to 1 only when both the inputs are 0. All other cases, we will get an output 0. For NOR gate, we are taking an input condition 0, 0. That is A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0. Then you just check A is equal to 0 means M3. VGS is equal to 0. Then VS is equal to VDD. So VGS of M4 is, sorry, I am taking M4. A is connected to M4. VG of M4 is 0, VS of M4 is VDD, so VGS is equal to VDD, so M4 is on, that means that VDD is transferred to the source of M3. Now you go for B, B have input 0, input 0 means naturally VG of M3 is equal to 0, VS of M3 is VDD because M4 is conducting. So VGS of M3 become VDD. VGS of M3 is VDD means M3 is on. Now M4 is on, M3 is on. So there be a possibility if the capacitor is connected, the capacitor connected at the output point will charge or it will attain a potential VDD that is equal to 1. Now you want to check, is any possibility of discharging? Once it is charging, is any possibility of discharging? Possibility of discharging is, one is through M1, another is to M2, because two parallel paths are there, so you have to take one by one. Now we are saying the case of M1, B is equal to 0, that means VG of M1 is equal to 0, VS of M1 is equal to 0, because the source of NMOS is the lowest potential, naturally the source is at ground. So VGS of M1 is equal to, VG is equal to 0, VS is equal to 0, that is 0 minus 0, naturally it is 0. Similarly, so VGS 0 means M1 is off. Similarly, if you are analyzing for M2, VG is equal to 0, VS is equal to 0, VGS is equal to 0, M2 is off. So there will not be any possibility of discharging. So the output capacitor is at 1. Now we are going for any other condition. A is equal to 1, B is equal to 0, then what will happen is A is equal to 1 means for transistor M4, VG is equal to VDD, VS is equal to VDD, so VGS is equal to VDD minus VDD, that is 0, so M4 is off. Once M4 is off, even M3 is on, there will not be any possibility of charging because it is open circuited. Now we have to check the discharging possibility. Discharging possibility, M1, the previous condition itself, because B is equal to 0, VG of M1 is equal to 0, VS of M1 is equal to 0, so VGS is equal to 0, M1 is off, so it will not discharge, provide a discharge path. But going to M2, the input of A is equal to now VDD, that is 1, so VG of M2 is EDD, VS of M2 is 0, so VGS is equal to VDD, M2 is on. So if the capacitor is previously charged, that is, it will discharge. That is, first M4 is off, so it will not charge. Even previous condition, output is charged, M2 will provide a discharging path. It will ensure that it will go to 0. That is, A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0, output becomes 0. Now if you go for the ulta, that is, A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1, what will happen is, M3 is on, M4 is off, sorry, M4 is on, M3 is off, so the path is not serious, so it is not a continuous path, there will not be any charging possibility. Now M1 is on and M2 is off, so there will be a discharging path, that is through M1. Now if you are going for both on a particular condition, that is A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1, then the condition become M3 and M4 off, so there will not be any charge path. And coming to M1 and M2, both the gate potentials are VDD and both the source potentials are ground, so both the VGS become VDD, both the transistors are on, so there is a discharge path. So if even if the transistor the capacitor is previously charged, M1 and M2 will ensure that that will change to 0. So the condition is when A and B is equal to 0, NOR gate get an output 1. All other condition NOR gate will get an output 0. Okay. Now we will check some conditions. That is, this is actually, I am just avoided the NMOS side, because you get a NOR gate, 3 input NOR gate. How you can design a 3 input NOR gate is in the top figure. That is A, B and C, series. So it becomes A plus B plus C, the whole bar. Going to the bottom side, what will happen is A, B and C in parallel, that will ensure that a discharging path. Okay. Now we'll go for how to implement A dot B dot C. It is in the second figure. All the PMOS has to be parallel. Now you will take the circuit and analyze it, then you can identify what exactly the conditions. You just set the top transistors. A bar is in parallel with the rest of the circuit. So it is, you can write A bar into. Now you check B and D bar is parallel. So B, D bar, that is a product. That is in series with the C bar. So you can write B, D bar plus C bar into A bar. Then you can write it as the whole bar because you are implementing a negative logic. So the function from here itself, we can write, that is B, D bar plus C bar into A bar, the whole bar, that is the function. So actually, I have a plan to give a, so the reverse side, if you check, A is in parallel with all the transistors, so naturally first you want to draw A bar is in parallel with all transistors in pull up, so you have to draw A bar in series with the rest of the circuit. Then here B and D bar is in series in opposite side, that is down, B and D bar is in parallel, series. Then in the top side, that combination is in series with the C bar. So here it is in parallel with the C bar. So whatever the serial connection in top is replaced by a parallel connection. Whatever the parallel connection in top is replaced by a serial connection. So we can write the functionality from the top. Actually, I have a plan because whiteboard is not working. Yes, you can analyze another circuit. That is here you can check, find out that A bar, B, B bar. And A and B is parallel, so naturally it is AB. A bar, B bar is parallel, so it is A bar, B bar. So two product names are AB and A bar, B bar. That is in series because we are taking the first one and the second one, it is series. So it become A bar, B bar plus AB. The whole bar is natural because it is a negative logic implementation. So the function is AB, A exclusive B, or you can write A bar, B bar plus AB, the whole bar. Whatever the connections in top, that is series, AB is in series. So here, AB is in parallel. So here you can see at the bottom, AB is in series. That is in series with A bar, B bar. Here it become in parallel with a series connection of AB, A bar, B bar. Okay. Now I am taking one more implementation, that is I am showing only the PMOS side on the top and NMOS side on the bottom. Take the PMOS side on the top. You can see two transistors A and B are parallel, so naturally there will be a term AB. Then if you are moving, C is in parallel with two transistors D and E. D and E is, so you have to write D plus E, and it is in parallel with C, so you have to write C into D plus E. So that combination is in series with AB. So your function is AB plus C into D plus E. Then the total implementation is complementary or negative, so the whole bar. So if your question is implement A dot B plus C into D plus E, then what you have to do is at the output, you have to draw one more inverting gate, that is NAND gate. So these implementations are called static CMOS implementation. These are the static CMOS circuit design methods. So you can just check a function F is equal to PQ plus R into S plus T, the whole bar. This is a university question. The whole bar is just given. Normally in university, there will not be any functionality. So where the inverted mark is appears, is it totally outside, means it is for the whole. If it is just outside the bracket of S plus T, that is means it is just for that functionality. Okay, you just check where it is. So it is VQ plus R into S plus T, the whole bar. You can have a paper and pencil, try to implement it. So I'm waiting for 1 or 2 minutes. Once you complete it, you can give a feedback. Completed, then we will come back. Okay, I got a message from Arjun. Okay. Okay, me Raja, and I got a message. Okay. Mohammad asked if I got only your message now. I'm not sure what happens. It may be because of your connection problem. Anyhow, later we will. Put it in a YouTube channel that is created by a department so you can hear the. Amrita, I hope it is 28 people are here. That means most of them are here. But I am not sure about what is exactly happening. In terms of audibility and all the things, anyhow. So, what is the answer for this question? It is simply the same. Sorry. Yeah, it is PQ, RN2, ST the whole bar. Here, instead of that, AB. C into D plus C. So replace A and B with a P and Q and R with a C and ST with a D and E. Oh, sorry, D and E with ST. So that is your answer. Because I want to ensure that you try some problems. If you have any problem, anything that you cannot follow, you just come back to me. Even you can send mails or anything, because this is an easy portion. You can score any marks. There's any function. First of all, you identify the basic thing is the implementation is negative. So in your question paper, there is no negative. That is, there is no bar in your question. You have to go for a first answer is bar. So our final answer, you have to add an inverter. Draw an inverter at the output, then you will get the final answer. Okay? So anything you want, because we are just going to wind up, it is something around 1 hour. Tomorrow we have a section from 11 to 1. By that time, I hope we can complete the fourth module. Then we may have two or three sections. We will cover the fifth and sixth module. The one thing that is you have to follow is in case of fourth module itself, there is some portions that is description things. That is available with the whatever KTU notes I shared. If you don't have it, I will share it now. Do you want the KTU? Just I will check, there'll be an option to share a file here. Okay, I will send, I hope I already sent a link, but those who are not downloaded the things, I will send the KTU notes, that is official notes from KTU for the fourth module. I will share it in our Gmail group. Okay. So we are going to wind up the things. Anything you want to feedback, you can give the feedback. Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm.